Hello everyone, and welcome to this new tutorial about Synteny's GNSS simulator, Constellator. In this video, we will show how to configure and start our very first simulation. We will also stop a minute on the main monitoring interfaces provided by the GUI. Let's get on with it. When unboxing the Constellator, the package should contain the following items: a server, a power cable, an RJ45 Ethernet wire for the HMI. First of all, the server. This is the masterpiece, the one that hosts the computation power and the signal generation board. To this day, there are four models of Constellator available, providing different computation power or option availability. Okay, now that the Constellator is out of the box, let's focus on the first installation. First of all, we need to install the server in a dry, tempered, and safe from shock environment near to a secure electrical outlet. Secondly, we need to install the GUI application and set up the communication link between the server and the HMI. Please check that your server and your GUI are connected to the same Ethernet network or connected by Ethernet link one to the other. The first things to do on HMI computer, so it's to install the GUI application. To do so, use the setup executable provided with the Constellator server. Please remember that each version is compatible with one version of the GUI. You shall not use another GUI than the one provided with the server. So, let's install the GUI application together. Just use the setup executable provided, like this. Click Next, Next. Wait a little bit for it to install. And we are good. Once installed, we need to configure the IP address of the server in the communication configuration file of the GUI application. To do so, open the GUI install directory. Like this, using the open file location option on Windows. Then we are looking for the file called rtg2gui_com. Let's edit it. And now, on the third line, you see the IP address, the expected IP address of the RTG2 server. There, we need to configure the right address. For mine, it's 0.158. Let's save it. And then, just open the application to check if the communication is on. We got a TM state with a green light and an idle status. Our GUI is now connected. So let's launch our very first GNSS simulation with Constellator. When you open the GUI for the first time, you should check that the communication link is on between the GUI and the server. A green light in the TM state and an idle state on the server status indicates that the communication are on and operational. Sometimes you may see a red light and a status panel displaying a disconnected status. When this happens, you have three checks to perform. One, checks that both your server and your GUI are connected to the same Ethernet network. Two, check that your server is powered on. Three, check that your configured IP address is the right one. Okay, now let's configure our very first Constellator simulation. To do so, you need to click on the right icon on the top left corner and then click on the new button in the dialog box. This will open a configuration editor in which number of parameters will be able to be configured. For now, we are just focusing on one or two for the purpose of the quick start demo. For instance, in the general panel, you can see the time parameters section right here, when you can choose between three time of system time, UTC local time or GPS. Here we are going to choose GPS and keep the default parameters. The second things to do will be to select the number of signals to be simulated during the run. By default, you can see that GPS L1CA is already enabled, but let's say we want to add a Galileo E1 signals. To do so, you only need to click on the Galileo tab, activate the constellation by clicking the checkbox,
and then activate the signals in the bottom part of the panel, enabling E1B by clicking the checkbox and enabling E1C by clicking the other checkbox. Finally, let's configure a specific trajectory, and why not a satellite trajectory? To do so, please go to the User Motion panel. In the Trajectory Type section, choose Dynamic Position, and for the environment, select In Space. As you can see, in the second section, Trajectory Parameters, new parameters are available to select. For the purpose of the video, I will keep again the default parameters. Once you have configured a starting time, a constellation and signals to emulate, and a trajectory, you can save your configuration. You give it a name, like demo, and save it. Once saved, you can leave the editor by clicking the close button, and it's now time to load your configuration by selecting it in the dialog box and load it. You can see the progress bar, meaning that the configuration is currently downloaded to the server. And now you can see the server status in the status panel, namely displaying configured. This means that your server is ready to start. So now let's click on the play button to start our simulation. The first thing you can see is the server status, which is now showing running open loop status, which means that your server is currently broadcasting GNSS signals. Now, as you can see on the top in the toolbar, you got a lot of icons that will allow you to display different kinds of widgets, which will help you monitor the simulation currently running. The first one I want to show you is a PVT widget. As you can see on this panel, you can have in real time the position of the mobile in ECEF or in geodetic position, the velocity in ECEF or ENU position, a coordinate, and also the time parameters, initial time, current time, and simulation time, the time elapsed during the simulation. The second panel I want to show you is the channel panel. In this panel, we have the list of signals currently broadcasted. You can see they are classified by constellations, GPS first, Galileo then, and by signal, L1CA, followed by N1B, E1C, and for each satellite, of course. So these are the two main widgets to monitor the activity of the simulator. As you can see in the toolbar, there are a lot more widgets that you can use, such as power monitoring of GNSS signals, or the sky plot, where you can display all active satellites, or even the ground track, where the trajectory of the satellite will be drawn on the world map. But we won't focus on them for today. On another hand, if you want to process and analyze data afterwards, you will have to log the GNSS data in specific files. To do so, you have two ways with Constellator. The first and easiest way is to click the autolog option in the configuration, and you will have them automatically dropped in the autolog directory in the installation folder of the GUI. Here you can see that Constellator is currently dropping NMEA logs, data logs, and command logs. The other way to log GNSS data from the simulator is to activate them manually, thanks to this button in the top left corner, the one called Log Management. You just need to click on them, and the dialog box offers you a way to configure a specific logging behavior. As you can see, by clicking on New, I can add a new log file of type data like this. I will be able to add a name to this log file. Let's call him, let's put it in the autolog directory and call it manual log. Save the name. And then you just need to activate the logging manually by clicking on the active button right there. You can make it run and stop them whenever you want by clicking on the active button again. And that's it for the logging session. So we're almost done with our demonstration of the first quick start with Constellator. The last thing I need to show you is how to stop the simulator. To do so, you just need to click on the stop button that replaces the start button right here in the top left corner. By clicking on it, you will see that the server status will switch back to configured as it was before, and the message showing that the simulator stopped in the message box. Well, that's all for the first step with Constellator. I hope you enjoy it and find it useful. See you soon for more tutorials, in which we will examine furthermore the simulation possibilities provided by the Constellator.